So my name is Jonathan Schor. I'm an entering MSTP student, and I'm working in the Gladstone building here at UCSF on our Mission Bay campus in Yadong Huang's lab. The idea behind the Huang Lab's research is we're focusing on the disease of Alzheimer's. One of the things that drew me towards this lab and towards disease-related neurosciences, I wanted to take all of the sort of exciting skills and exciting finds that I'd had in lab in a basic sense, and hopefully then apply them to something that was applicable to a disease. I come from a family that has always been into cognitive sciences. My mom is a child neurologist, and my dad is a neurophysiologist. And through whatever reason, we also happen to, in our family, have a lot of people that exhibit some sort of neurological abnormalities later in life. Growing up, talking science with my parents was sort of, that was our dinner table conversation. And it wasn't something that I necessarily felt pushed into, but it was definitely something that, you know, I saw them be excited about it, and without even sort of intending to, I also became excited. So my time is now split between two things. One is a lot of coding. Before I got to college, I had never done any sort of computer science or writing code or anything like that. And even in college, a lot of my fellow scientists weren't necessarily interested in coding because they said, like, oh, I can just get so-and-so to do it because that's their job, you know, they're a computer scientist or something like that. It's right now, half of what I do in lab is writing code. The other half is actual biological experimentation. So, you know, we have these brains that we're looking at that we want to discern exactly how memory loss occurs in Alzheimer's. And we use these various techniques like channel rhodopsin, this light-triggered neuronal activation, to sort of parse out exactly what it is that is causing some of these memory losses that we see in our Alzheimer's cases. Really, this type of research is not only important, it's almost necessary for an aging population right now. You know, what with baby boomers now reaching sort of a stage in their life where they're now much more likely to get Alzheimer's, it's really important that this research be done. From a purely selfish standpoint, I just really find it challenging and fun. A lot of what neuroscience in particular is going towards is computation, and that's something I really enjoy. So you know, you get to be the one person that is coding up something that has not yet been made. You know, you, in many cases, if there's a tool that you need and it's not out there, you have to make it. And at the same time, there's this huge technological boom that allows you to have very fine control over neurons within the brain. So the advent of channel rhodopsin, which is basically this really cool tool that allows you to trigger neurons within the brain just by turning on a light. That makes neuroscience such an exciting field to work in that it's hard for me not to be motivated to continue working in it. On the other side of things, there's always the motivation of, you know, no matter how far in the future a treatment may be or some sort of therapy may be, it's definitely rewarding to know that you're working on something that actually is affecting humans. And no matter what small amount you can contribute, it's working towards something that is a very positive change. I think the biggest thing is not to feel like you should be afraid to approach a potential mentor or, you know, somebody that, you know, if you're interested in working in someone's lab, let's say you're a high school student and you want to work in a lab, you really have nothing to lose by just emailing somebody that you read, all these universities publish little bios about what the professors are doing. You read a bio, you see what interests you, and you just send an email. And I think oftentimes the biggest stumbling block that people face when they're trying to get into science is they're worried that if I don't already know this stuff beforehand, why would anyone be interested in taking me into their lab? Like, maybe I haven't taken a single biology class or a single chemistry class. Why would somebody be interested in having me? And the reason is because scientists as a whole love to have new minds to bring into science. We love our science, and we want other people to love our science too, and get other people interested in science. So really, just by sending that email and saying, like, you know, I have this amount of experience, or I have no experience, but I'm interested, will really go a long way towards getting you, your hands dirty and getting into the field.